to the Silent Hill Ascension pre-show. I'm Layla. Here's the much requested Noah. Noah, I believe you have the run of show for us.
Yes, I do, Laluchka. And it's great to see you again here on our show. So right now we're on our pre-show. That's 5:40 Pacific time PM on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. And we have the show on weekdays at 6 p.m. Pacific. And we have the post show right after the show on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. So be sure to catch those. Layla, what else do we have here today?
Well, for those of you who might not know or are joining us for the first time or otherwise plumb forgot, Silent Hill Ascension is a socially interactive streaming series where all of you collectively shape and experience its evolving story. Collaborate and compete with others to try to make the choices you want. So when each decision ends, that choice locks in as canon, and that is the version of the show everyone sees. A canon story shaped by you, the participating audience, every single day. And for you right now, we have a setup scene where Astrid questions Detective Haugen about her son Orson's case and learns that Britt went on a destructive bender.
Worst day of my life since my daughter died. You remember that day, Leo? The day Asta died?
Olivia, there's no way anyone could forget that day.
No. There isn't. You'd think they'd understand. Have a little empathy for me after 15 years. But no. They wouldn't even let me back in the building to collect my things. Great, it's you. Here to gloat?
No. I'm here for answers. Why were you suspended? What did they find?
They thought I wasn't impartial enough to solve your son's missing persons case.
That doesn't make sense. I turned myself into you.
That's what I told them.
Your partner said new information came to light about Orson. What was it?
They think I'm crazy. That's what came to light, okay?
Why would they think that?
Doesn't matter. But what does matter is that your son is probably as dead as my daughter.
Don't say that.
Do you even remember my daughter's name? Huh? It was Asta. And she was only 6 when-
Oh no, you don't! Get out!
The hell?
After you broke my tables yesterday, you're never coming in here again.
I wasn't anywhere near here yesterday.
Guess I'm not the only one with troubles.
Wait!
Astrid, tell this crone idiot that I haven't touched a glass in this place.
Liar! I saw you with my own eyes.
To hell with this! I'm out of here!
Don't go, Britt. Let's get this sorted out.
There's nothing to sort out. I won't take the blame for something I didn't do. Go fuck yourself.
Britt, wait.
Welcome back, everybody. We hope you enjoyed that. And also, chat, we do see you and we missed you too. So thank you all for your lovely messages. We're seeing it. Makes us feel great. Let's take a moment. Noah, let's have a little chat about what just happened. Seems like Britt doesn't quite remember whether or not what she was up to recently.
And we've all been there, right?
I'm there every day. I got Swiss cheese for breaks.
Yeah, so sometimes you don't remember, especially, you know, she has substance abuse in her past. It does cause the Swiss cheese effect. And, you know, and there's a lot going on right now. Like, Astrid is under immense pressure, and Britt, I don't know how Britt managed to make this about her. Like, it's not her son. She was not even in the country forever. And now all of a sudden it's like, look, maybe I'm relapsing. Oh.
Well, in Britt's defense, she didn't make it about her so much as Leho did.
Right.
But she's certainly, you know, not trying to deflect attention from the fact that she's sharing the spotlight with poor missing Orson. But we have that going on, and also something's up with that Detective Haugen.
She's at the end of her rope. She's like, this case that Johansson's, this case has driven her mad, it seems. And she's lost her job right now. She's like, she has nothing left to do than join Britt on a bender.
That lady is at the, like you said, she's at the end of her rope. She's very stressed. And you know what else? Too close to the case. And actually, we got someone in the chat. Jeffrey Aiton. That's the pronunciation we're gonna go with. Says hi,
like
sus, very sus. I like that also. It's a very good username.
Definitely, it's definitely sus. And like, basically, I'm starting to think. I was kind of suspecting Carl in the beginning about things, and I was suspecting Astrid about things. But I'm starting, for me personally, the blame is shifting here in Norway. I don't know.
Oh, you're starting to try to get Britt under that bus, huh?
I don't know. Maybe I see her as my scapegoat. Maybe.
I see. And hey, everyone's gotta have a scapegoat.
but dude, it's terrifying. Like, the delusions that Astrid or whatever it is she's hearing that makes her think that she hurt her child. How terrifying is that? But speaking of Astrid dealing with things, we do have our decision that's closing today, which is, how will Astrid react to Britt's denial? That's a fate question. So, fate decision. So, will she tell her to stop lying, which is the redemption option, or tell her to let it go, which is suffering, or tell her you believe her, which is the damnation option? Tough one here.
Always interesting that the not nice thing is perhaps the redemption thing, right? The kind thing. Tell her to stop lying, because hey, we don't actually have any confirmation either way of Britt is lying. Is she? Was she actually at Leho's bar? Was it one of those things that, you know, everyone keeps seeing things that aren't really there? Who's to say?
Right, and it's there's also I'm very excited because I'm seeing that people here are reacting in the chat. But she does have to figure out what to do with her sister. She has these like crazy anxiety-inducing delusions. And with Britt, it's like, again, it's like a case of like, is she being gaslit? And is this kind of like a plot? What's really going on? Has she really relapsed? Is somebody relapsing her? Like, you know, sometimes people get suicided. I don't know. Have you ever heard this term?
No, Noah, as with a great deal of things you say, that is the first time.
It's like, said it. Yeah, it's when it's sus. But yeah, let's talk about fate and hope, because speaking of sus things and things that can keep us alive here, though. So we have all our decisions and endurance scenes and puzzles. All of them contribute to whether characters will face redemption, suffering, or damnation in the Silent Hill Ascension grand finale. So their fate is decided across the length of the season, and the character's hope needs to be high enough for them to survive a crucial story moment. What does that mean, Layla?
So fate and hope, right? Fate, we just talked about a fate decision. You got redemption, you got suffering, you got damnation. Those are your kind of fate paths. And depending on how you, the audience, make decisions, a character will start kind of trending towards a certain ending. Meanwhile, hope is decided secondarily as part of the mini games that you can play and as part of the endurance scene. So when the endurance scenes pop up, you see that little dial that fills up and down. That's your hope meter. And right now there's some characters where that hope meter is pretty dang low. And I'll say, poor Mr. Toby, ripped to a king, his hope meter was real, real low. And if it hadn't been, you know, perhaps he would have met a different end. But we'll at least for now, we won't know, you know, what could have possibly happened, because unfortunately, as I said, rip to a king. But you have plenty of opportunities by playing endurance scenes and minigames to raise the hope gauges for characters that you like, or honestly, sabotage hope gauges for characters you don't. Noah, would you like to tell us about how influence points work?
Yeah, so you can use sinisterly your influence points should you want to. Once the decision is made by the audience, it's canon. So there's no reset button. What you decide is what goes forever. And these decisions are defined by the influence points that you, the audience, uses to participate in them to influence the narrative. So the more influence points you have, the more sway you will have for the decisions you care about. So you can earn influence points by taking part in endurance scenes during the live shows, and we'll explain in a bit, we'll talk more about endurance, or by doing the puzzles, which you know I'm a sucker for, or alternatively, you can gain them via direct purchase or a season pass.
Absolutely. Let's take a look at one of today's closing decisions to see an example of the fate system.
Right. So as we said, like, this is an example coming to life in front of us. How will Astrid react to Brit's denial? Which, by the way, the wording here implies that there is this denial. I don't know. Maybe it didn't happen. But anyway, we have to decide here if she's going to tell her to stop lying, which would be the redemption option, or tell her to let it go, which is the suffering option, or tell her you believe her, which is the damnation option. And again, no good deed goes unpunished here in Silent Hill Ascension. You think you might be doing the right thing, but it clearly says that there is damnation afoot. So I said afoot. It sounds funny when I say it. Leila, can you please give me some more context? Give all of us some more context.
Yeah, sure. Context afoot, as we were. So yeah, it's you know, for the redemption path, you know, characters who have been mired in you know, whatever they've been mired in, it depends on who exactly we're talking about, right? We've got Astrid, who's not quite all there in terms of her family history, which we're still piecing together. Rachel and the Foundation. Are you going to set them on a redemptive path to kind of like recognize what they've been doing wrong and move forward? Are you going to set them to like torment, right? it's to borrow from Christianity, purgatory, right? Are you gonna let them kind of wallow in it without really going in any direction, or are you gonna set them to the damnation path? You know,
you'll the get damnation to choose path, here.
Yeah, it's listen,
we
that see,
we saw how, yeah, we saw how that worked out. And also, like, we're going to talk about it later in our post show, but we do this week, y'all better pay attention this week, because a lot of stuff is going down and a lot of potentially very gory stuff might go down. So we do have, like, we're coming close on the decision here about how will Astrid react to Brit's denial. Right now, it seems like damnation is winning. So people
not
are really
much.
Trying to be, not by much. It's like, it's a close tie with redemption here. So take your pick. You can still do the wrong thing and be right as it goes here. Or I guess.
Yeah, we do that all the time on the show.
Right.
Yeah, it is about a, just by my quick and pathetic math, 58,000 influence point gap between the two. You got a couple minutes, and if you've got enough enthusiasm, you could certainly turn the tide. Suffering gang, you've got a long way to go. If someone's been really hoarding some influence points, you know, you could make it happen if you tried.
Leila,
so, yeah.
Before the break, when we were starting to see some kind of a suffering trend, and I feel like suffering had a moment where it seemed like it's gonna be the dominant for a second. But I don't know. It seems like we're back to being either like, you know, paving our road to hell with good intentions or paving our road to heaven with horrible intentions. I don't know how to put that, but what is for sure is that the time on the decision is closing soon.
That is correct. As we just said, there's, you know, still some wiggle room if you want to flip that damnation choice. And hey, as it's almost time for the show, it is time for production to put up the endurance scene, and Noah will walk you through it.
Let's endure this together, ladies and gentlemen. So one of our main story characters enters the room only to find one of you, an audience member, dead, being eaten by a snarler. So sorry, this is the situation. But the snarler is a dog-like monster that feeds on human flesh and definitely not a boy you want to pet, you know, at your own risk. The character gets attacked by another snarler and will have to kick it off and escape, avoiding obstacles thanks to inputs from you, the audience. Layla, can you tell us a bit more about this?
Yeah, so as we were saying earlier, this is a big chance for you to influence that hope meter, because if a character fails enough endurance scenes, they may not survive future encounters, leading to their permanent death and, hey, let's face it, probably potential dismemberment maybe in the story. These endurance scenes are one of the best places to earn large amounts of influence points. So remember, success or failure is a part of the collective story and not an individual judgment on your skill, unless you are personally motivated by individual judgment, in which case you can pretend I am watching you and judging you. It is my role as your auntie. I just want you to improve.
Right. The judgy aunties are back. So y'all can be judged if you so desire. But basically, we're not going to judge you. but I love that, like, people really need to pay attention to this. Because again, like you said, Toby could have been maybe starting a new life somewhere, you know? Maybe if we were doing the endurance scenes with vigor. And I think that now is, because I said vigor, now you're like, okay. this is the time for everybody to show up in the endurance scene. And if you want somebody to survive, there's really a good way to do it. And that's clicking the input that will tell you on the screen. Mm-hmm. That can save a life.
Absolutely. And hey, we're about 2 minutes away from the show, which means we are just slightly a few more minutes away from those endurance scenes. Get your tapping fingers or your mouse fingers ready. But since we are just kind of slowly rolling our way back into the show, let's do a little recap, which is, you know, in Pennsylvania and in Norway, we got a child missing. In Pennsylvania, Faith is missing. In Norway, Orson is missing. In Norway, Orson's mom, Astrid, getting kind of dogged by Aurora, who we actually haven't seen in a minute, the social worker. And now we're finding out that Haugen is on administrative leave because she's too close to the case. Meanwhile, in Pennsylvania, Rachel and Eric's marriage is, I think to put it kindly, falling apart a little bit. We have our favorite minx, Krista, getting kind of involved in that mix. So we got a lot going on in both places. The story is absolutely ramping up, so buckle in. We're in for a ride from now until the end of the season. But for now, we will be back in for the post show, Noah and I, so don't miss us too much. But in the meantime, we absolutely hope that you enjoy the show, that you'll stick around for the post show, because we got a lot of goodies for you. you know, for now, have a wonderful evening, and we'll see you in a few.